die.
You'll be all right.
What's it supposed to feel like? You've been shot more than anybody I know. I'm gonna be okay.
Wilkes.
I'll live.
You're dying, Wilkes.
Are you all right?
Is that a joke?
I'm sorry.
Turn.
You're headed for Myanmar. The mission's not over.
What about Wilkes?
We're scrambling for a replacement. We might have a runner in Japan we could borrow, a woman named Cohen.
What's in Myanmar?
Nikoladze. We used the Kalinatech data to pinpoint him at the Chinese embassy in Rangoon.
Chinese support for the Georgians?
The political situation isn't good. If they are backing Nikoladze, you better find rock-solid proof. I don't want to go into World War III without a good reason. You've got some time before you reach Rangoon. Do you want me to patch a secure phone line so you can talk to Sarah?
No.
Disaster was narrowly averted at the Pickett Gap Water Treatment Plant in Tennessee. Plant management attribute the malfunction to a remote viral attack, possibly the latest act of terror in the Georgian information crisis. Still have no leads in the search for Combain Nikoladze. NATO and charity groups working in Azerbaijan continue to uncover the corpses left from what was only the beginning of the Georgian president's campaign of high-tech terror. If not for the swift intervention of plant employees, hundreds or even thousands could have become life-threateningly ill from contaminated water.
They say we're safe and all right, but then they tell us to boil our water.
Seeing the disaster averted at Pickett Gap, a possible turning point in the Georgian information crisis, marking the first time American authorities were able to recognize and overcome one of Nikoladze's acts of terror. Described early diplomatic negotiations with China a mixture of silence and antagonism. The Chinese claimed that the U.S. are using suspicions of Georgian support as an unfounded excuse to inspect Chinese weapon stores, and have so far refused cooperation. If possible, lending an even greater urgency to the search for Combain Nikoladze.
Then there's a pretty sensitive guy, isn't he? Wilkes is like, I'm gonna live. And he's like, nope, you're dying, Wilkes. You're dying for sure. Anyway, Chinese embassy, Yangon, Myanmar. Burma, Myanmar. Okay. November 11th, 2004, 2030 NAS. Find the Georgian-Chinese connection. Using intelligence gleaned from the Pickett Gap program, Third Echelon has traced communications between Nikoladze and the Chinese embassy to Myanmar. Any suspected connection between Nikoladze and the People's Republic of China must be proven before any action can be taken.
Your contact is in place. Our man in Burma or Myanmar.
Whatever. Where do I find him?
A rooftop a few blocks from the embassy. Says he's under a large red sign. To respond to the phrase, a bright cold day in April. We've updated your opsat. To be clear, if you kill anybody, this mission's over. If you slip up on this one...
I'll find a fallout shelter and learn some prayers.
I'm glad you understand. Be good.
So, greetings fellow oldlings. Welcome back with some more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. This mission is... well... it's full of stealth, I like that part, but it's also long and reminds me of, yeah, so this mission pretty much reminds me of, the wanted variant of this guy, what do you call it? Pandora Tomorrow, yeah. So this mission is quite reminiscent of Pandora Tomorrow, and, well, so let's try out a few strats here. I don't really know how to deal with this guy. We should be able to just run forwards, and that should solve a problem for the most part. Oh wait, there's a pipe here. I didn't even notice that. And this pipe seems to lead nowhere in particular. That's not how you play this. Okay, so... yeah. We're just going to be slow here, and I don't really know where the other guy is who saw me the last time, so... Where is this guy? But yeah, this level is actually quite long. There's a long infiltration phase throughout the streets, and that pretty much just becomes sort of a pain after a point. God. That's nice and smooth. I wonder who saw me crossing over to this side, if that might help. Yeah, there is a space behind this, which we may be able to exploit. Let me just quick save here, just in case we get seen. We didn't, amazing. And so that is the correct way to play this. I'll just stay here for the time being. Make sure that guy isn't looking at us, and once he isn't, be free to go. I mean, I'll just let him come over onto this side. That's as far as you go, huh? Not really, no. You come all the way over here. Why did you stop there? No, you don't. That's amazing. So apparently these guys have some turrets, which they can use, and we just want to be careful of them. I'll just save the game here again. I'm pretty sure I think I knocked that guy out the first time around I played this level, and this is where you want to head really slow. As you can see, there are some lit areas here which you want to avoid. There are some people who are walking around downstairs, and you just want to make sure that you get up to this platform here.
I saw something.
You did, didn't you? Be careful when you jump up here. Of course you did. It's fine. It's fine. They're really not going to pitch into you, get in your way. You can... I suppose I can save here. I'm not sure, of course. But I feel rather confident in thinking that I can. Anyway, I mean, they're not looking up here, so... more power to us, I guess? Anyway, so here's the zipline which you want to take over to this side, and from there on out we've got ledges which we can use. Nice. Yeah, that should help us minimize our profile and help us avoid being seen by these guys. I'm not quick saving for the time being because, well, apparently it's not a quick rope, it's not a zipline, it's a tight rope for us to use. And this is as good a place as any, I suppose, to save again, but I'm not really going to do that. Yeah, let's just keep going. We got a medikit here, which we can pick up, and let's just go into this corner and quick save. And those guys should not be disturbing us anymore. We can take out the slide if we want to, but that'll just attract more attention to us, which we do not want. So yeah, that guy appears to be glitched out. And yeah, we seem to be in the relative shadow, with nobody actually looking at us, or at our general direction anyway. Seems good enough, I suppose. Let me just quick save here, because as far as I remember, I think I need to jump onto this pipe to grab it. Yeah. You probably are. Yes, sir. No, you do not. It's all fine. I dislike how sometimes in this game, these guys just tend to, you know. You can't exactly land soft when you press the jump button, and pressing the jump button is practically the only way of certain things such as ladders and a lot. So there's this guy right here. Wait, let me just quick save here. Okay. Oh, smooth as butter, just like that. Go on. We can gain a little more speed now. It's fine. They will notice us, and yeah. So apparently that's how we clear that level. I completely forgot about it. Completely. See, as long as you crouched, it's all fine, but as soon as you press the jump button, everybody suddenly knows where you are. And that really does not help a lot. Oh, I did quick save up there, didn't I? So let's just go into the corner here. Right here, and yeah, I'll just create another save. Not that I needed to save there, but seriously, think about this part. The corridor down the middle, that's in complete darkness. You can literally waltz right through that part. Nobody's going to bat an eye at you. Nobody shall notice you. Right here. You can stick to the gates, and again, nobody will notice you. It's yeah, just make sure that they aren't looking in a general direction when you do that. Or, you know, just heading towards you in general. This guy is also danger here. It's not that big of an issue, but you just might want to be a little careful. We can proceed down the center line here. Just rush here, and here is your safe spot. I'm just going to quick save here, and I'm going to attempt a maneuver. They shouldn't really notice me, but oh well. Well done. Well done, if I say so myself. I'm just going to save here again. Excuse me. So yeah, sorry about that. Commentating can be a little difficult when, you know, you've got situations like these. So anyway. You should take it a little slow through these parts. Don't exactly want to alert everybody to our presence here. And I believe, yeah, there are a few points in this throughout the sewer where exploring it can be a little difficult. Is that all of them? Yes, that is all of them. Okay, we may move now. Just make sure you do it at a comparatively leisurely pace. I have already saved there, so if anything goes wrong. Because this is again one of those levels where a lot of things can go wrong. And you just want to make sure that you're on the right side of things when they do. For example, right now, yeah, I see that guy is about to turn and we don't want to get spotted by him. Excuse me. The earlier games weren't really all that refined, but for whatever they were still quite well made. Those guys are still standing there, so it's best not to go there. For now, at least. Just wait it out. Until they turn the corner or something. Because as you can see, this entire corridor is pretty lit. And there are very few shadows to hide in. Whoops, let me just go ahead and quick save here. And suddenly, this place goes dark. As soon as you approach it. And yeah, there's a guy over there, you do not want to mess with him. You do not want to upset him. Let him just stay where he is, as he is. The other guy that, you know, took this path down the right, he loops around and comes over to check that side, so that isn't exactly the safest hiding spot either. This might be a good location for me to pick safe. I may be able to recuperate my losses from here. The point in front of us is where it can get pretty difficult.
American version of terrorist cells, you know. Small, widely scattered, independent, high-tech, coordinated propaganda centers.
Aren't you clever?
You will see. We can kill their soldiers and flatten their capitals, but we will never beat their hamburger stands.
This is why I hate being on patrol with Tang.
Well, in a sense, he isn't wrong. I mean, there's an entire term around this thing that he just described called the mockocracy. You know, like these facets of democracy that you see all around you, be it McDonald's and stuff like that. Those weren't really a thing back in the day. They are now. They pretty much are now. And we just want to be a little quick here. This is our exit. We want to grab it before they grab us. Just go up a little and we're safe from whoever's above us and beyond us, below us. Because as you can see here, there's literally a guy right here. Alright then, so I guess half of the difficult part is over. Let me just go ahead and create a save here. Not 22, save 2. Yeah, thank you. Where do I go from here? Ah, yes. This pipe right overhead. I'll just go ahead and grab it. And we don't need to worry too much about
it.
I guess I'll just stay with things as they are right now. Just climb up into here and be a little slow. Because I don't remember whether this is the last thing, the last obstacle that we face or not. And yeah. Do you want a quick save here? Yeah, sure. So this is the guy that we want to contact. I guess.
It's a bright, cold day in April.
Good, good. Take this, okay? You late, but you here. Okay. We need to do this quickly.
Go ahead.
That map will show you the general's office in the courtyard.
I thought it was the ambassador's office.
It was, but some Chinese general has been using it. You can see for yourself. You get into the embassy grounds through the rear service entrance.
Is there a gate?
Yes, but a delivery truck will be pulling through shortly. You can sneak in past the truck, no problem. But you only have one chance at it.
Solid work.
I'm very good at my job. Okay, bye-bye.
Nice, nice, nice. So anyway, we just want to get up here. That is a rappelling point. Oh yeah, there's another medkit here. You can pick it up if you're looking to go in guns blazing. You won't really need it though. This next section is something which I found to be profoundly difficult, primarily because of the timing of the guards and how little space you actually have to hide. This is where the game will load into a new section again. So yeah, you can just go ahead and be a little slow. Just head over into this corner and stick to the wall. I hope that will give us some, you know, time before this guy shows up. Is there a guy? We can't even tell, can we? Yeah. So this is not a bad point to be making a new save. In fact, you should make a new save here because this section might take you a few tries to get down correctly. Let's just stay here until this guy decides to leave. There are some people over there. We do not want to piss off, for the time being at least. And yeah, let's just stick to this panel here and see how it goes. He should not be able to see us through that side now. If he doesn't, then it's a successful infiltration. He did not see us. He does have a satchel though, and I'm interested in what that says, because I haven't read it last time either. But oh well. I'm just going to quick save right now, because what I want to do next is pretty much follow that guy in the most discreet way possible. And just climb out this ladder here. That actually went better than expected, to be honest. Yeah, I just still do want to be wary of that guy because he can see right at us. And once that guy's gone, I'll just be proceeding along this ladder. Some people like to stick to the road, so you can do that as well. I just like the ladders though. Huh, where am I going? Where am I going? Oh wait, there's a ladder right there. My bad. I'm an idiot. Sorry guys, I'm just too stupid sometimes. And you still want to be slow here because there's another guy inside. And let me just quick save here. Let me just create an additional save here in case I've taken, you know, I fuck up, so to speak. Probably. Pardon my French. Yeah, so you do not want to be fast here, you want to be as slow as you can possibly be. There's a guy beyond that edge whom you do not want to piss off. Just keep walking slowly. Huh. Now, the last time what I did was I actually took to the ground because I can get up to this rappelling point here. There's actually a place where you can rappel from. I couldn't get there, so what I did the last time was I just literally stuck to the ground. I mean, I fell off basically and I stuck to the ground. Let me see if I can get up to the rappelling point this time. So wait, I can jump up on it without loading it. That is quite nice. Quite nice indeed. And he did not see me. Oh my god, this is the first time I've done this. Amazing. Great. Great, great, great. The more you know, I guess. And whatnot. Let me just create a new save here. Save one. Let me just overwrite it on save one. For the sake of convenience. And quick save here. Just in case, you know. I end up doing something I'm not supposed to do here. Anyway, this guy won't be coming our way. We can safely proceed ahead. There are no other patrollers here except for that guy who is looking dead at us right now for whatever reason of his own. We want to stick to this part though.
Word of caution, Fisher. That truck's going to be your only chance to get inside the embassy. Don't blow it.
Is there something going on I don't know about?
All you need to know is this. If you do find Nikoladze in there, be ready to scramble. One wrong step could mean war. If anybody in the embassy triggers an alarm, we're pulling you out. The mission's over.
This game just gave me 572 ammo, which I cannot use, like literally cannot use, because, well, stealth is one of the parameters of this game, but of this level at least. But yeah, so this guy, you want to be a little careful of this guy, I suppose. Don't worry about it, the truck isn't one of our largest priorities right now, and I probably should have quicksaved as I did right now. And we can take our time going through here. Just the next part is, yeah, so that guy, he pretty much we just want to make sure that this guy isn't looking at us. And the other guy from back there, he pretty much
Hello.
Hey, it's me again.
May I see your papers?
This is the seventh time tonight. Can we give the papers a rest?
This protocol comes directly from Feirong. Let me see your ID. Thank you. Authorization should only take a minute.
Nice. So yeah, so basically this is how you sneak into this compound. A few parts of this level required intense focus, and that is probably the reason.
Not the reason, that is the reason why
you're not hearing me commentate as much, you're not hearing me speak as much, but yeah. So basically that truck, as long as that truck is there, you can like literally just waltz into this place. What we do need to worry about here, except for these, for this patrolling guard and another guard in there, is a dog. The dogs in this game are actually quite nasty. If they see you, they'll charge you. If they don't see you, they'll sniff you out. And the thing is, you just need to constantly be on the move with them, as far as dogs are concerned. Let's go underneath the truck here. Where's the dog? Right there. It's a little... Dealing with dogs in this game is a little difficult. Just maintain your distance a little. For some reason, the dog was programmed not to, you know, disturb you on this part of your journey, on this arc at least. And yeah, just keep heading across over this part. Just keep going. And you want to be a little quick. Oh, good job. Good job. Let's try this strat here. Let's see here. Are there any pipes I can use? Not for the time being, apparently, no. Here?
Be more dead. The devices can be armed in one and placed the next. Of course the Ark, but you know the details. We need to strike together, or we may as well not strike at all. Nikoladze, listen to me, because you will reveal us. That's ridiculous. How could they listen? That's paranoia, but fine. No, fine. We will have a safe conversation. I will pull you back from my car.
And that's us.
Good Lord, Fisher. That's General Kong Ferong.
Good Lord. Who's that?
He was the chairman of China's Central Military Commission until 01. Very high PLA muckabook.
A Chinese general talking to Nikoladze isn't good news.
Whatever he's going to say when that conversation resumes just became our highest priority. Stay with him. Time to get invisible. Anyone so much as sees you and the mission's over.
So apparently the dog can only stick till there. But right now we just need to get our E-mic out, laser mic out again and scan this vehicle in front of us. So apparently what I was saying is the dogs have got limited range, at least in this part where they move, so I guess it's we're safe as far as this is concerned.
Not the only ones I'm worried about eavesdropping. They are just the most capable. Of course. How many times will the signal be rerouted? You also believe your Kola peninsula is untraceable. I understand the psychology of war. Yes, yes. I've attended many executions, but never American. But hold on a second. Driver, how far away is Mouke Tsoe Boe?
10 minutes, maybe more. But we'll have to stand a police check along the way.
No, it's not worth the trouble. I will just watch the broadcast like everyone else. Yes, too true. You are a wicked man, Mr. Nikoladze. I hope your performance goes well. Take care.
They're going to execute the soldiers.
Sounds like it.
You've got to stop them.
Well, let me just go ahead and save here. Sorry for the delay.
Rendezvous with Cole. I'll forward her the coordinates for Mouke.
Mouke Tsoe Boe.
Right.
Auspicious hunting ground.
Damn straight. The time for subtlety is past. I need to get this to the Joint Chiefs. See if this means war.
Okay, so that's done. Now all that's left is for us to exfiltrate out of the space. And yeah. That can be a bit of a challenge. These guards, they suddenly find their patrol patterns. I think there was a pipe here. I mean, not for this level anyway, for the next level, that is. Okay, I see. I see how it's gonna be. So yeah, you don't want this guy looking at us? Is this guy gonna come over? I think he is, isn't he? Damn! It's actually the closest I've been to anyone in this game. So... I do want to save here. I don't know whether that was a good decision or a bad decision, but I do have spare saves to fall back onto in case things go south. But yeah, here we go. This seems to be a pretty dark spot for us. I don't exactly know why, but it just is. And yeah, you just have to wait it out until the visual patterns of all of these people fall into place. You could have just jumped the gun and gone ahead with it before it was time, before it was due time. But yeah, we decided not to do that since we're gentlemen, and that did make things a little more difficult for us. But in the long run, it clears up a lot of things for us as well. The next stretch is this right here, and this does not really take much of an effort. I'm just gonna quick save again just for the heck of it. I guess this is where you could avoid the dog, in case the dog would come here, that is. Let me see here. Let's just go over and hope that they do not see us. Nice. Smoothly executed, and Coven is right there. And I guess I'll just... Nah, I don't need to. You done? Yeah.
Hop in the back. We gotta go. Grab hold of something.
So that was the mission, and it reminds me a lot of Pandora Tomorrow, the way the levels are crafted in Pandora Tomorrow, even though like Pandora Tomorrow is a game which came after this one, and how they're crafted in Double Agent. But it's like long ways to infiltrate into a place just to get the objective and get out, which is actually quite surprising given the fact that in Chinese Embassy 2, infiltrating is such a simple task. But anyway, I digress. Chinese Embassy, Yangon, Myanmar, November 11, 2004, 22:35 hours. Intelligence gathered at the embassy links Nikoladze the Gong Feirong, a prominent general in the People's Liberation Army of China, the PLA. Additional information reveals that captured American soldiers will be executed on Nikoladze's order during a webcast from Mouke Tsoe Boe meets, okay, a nearby slaughterhouse in a few short hours. And that's where we're heading to next, in order to stop it. So yeah, I mean the fact that the missions in Kola Peninsula were missing, the one mission, nuclear plant, it was missing. Sort of breaks the continuity of this game. It's from there that we get information about the Chinese's potential involvement, or something going on in Myanmar, Nikoladze being in Myanmar. So basically that is what we head over to investigate in this scenario, but we never get to do that since, as you can see, nuclear power plant is just missing, or nuclear plant, I don't remember the exact name of the level. So it's just missing from this version of the game, since I'm playing this on PC, and it's supposed to be exclusively for the PlayStation. But for all things said and done, something tips us off to Myanmar. We go to Myanmar and expecting to find Nikoladze there, but we find that he's in cahoots with what's this guy's name again? I forgot. Yeah, Gong Feirong. So he's in cahoots with Gong Feirong and a splinter faction of the Chinese military that is working separately against its government's wishes, and basically helping Nikoladze to his Georgian information crisis attack on the USA. So, and right now we found out that some American soldiers have been captured and they are ready to be executed in live broadcast. And that is where we are about to go ahead and, basically be a hero and save them. And another name which we haven't heard for a while, named Vyacheslav Grinko, will be popping up there as well. So anyway, moving on. This is the end of the video. I'll catch you guys in that regard in the next video, which should be coming out sometime soon. Sorry for the late uploads, I'm just getting stuck with a lot of work. Being a game developer isn't that easy, especially when you're shifting places and, just looking for new houses and stuff. But anyway, I will see you guys again in the next video. See you until I see you. Take care. Farewell, fellow. Thanks.